Founded by the French National Research Agency, DATAZERO Project is building an innovative, adaptive data center concept that optimizes both IT load and power consumption. DATAZERO Project brings together experts from the industry and laboratories to answer this question. The main targets of DATAZERO Project are mid-sized data centers up to 1 megawatt, where IT load is managed through virtualization commonly encountered in enterprise and public institutions. Recently, the industry has focused on increasing energy efficiency in data centers. However, the total amount of electricity needed for operating and hosting cloud services is still increasing, driven by the increased size of this infrastructure to support user concerns. Data centers are currently consuming more energy than the entire UK, and our needs are expected for further increase. Supplying them with only renewable energy is therefore essential to help mitigate climate change. Relying on the latest technologies and research in terms of renewable energy, electrical equipment, servers, and cloud management systems, DATAZERO aims at avoiding the energy consumption from the power grid in tomorrow's data centers. To make it simple, the question we address in DATAZERO is how to manage the electricity and the IT flow in order to deliver robust and efficient services to customers in data centers operating with several energy sources.
The data center is powered by two renewable primary sources in the form of photovoltaic panels and wind turbines. However, the energy production of these sources is hard to predict and intermittent, which means it depends on weather conditions. The issue is to find a solution to match the data center consumptions with the energy supply in real time.
To tackle this, two means of storage are used: lithium-ion batteries and hydrogen storage. Batteries handle short-term variability, for example between day and night, while hydrogen storage focuses on seasonal variability. Hydrogen storage combines an electrolyzer, tanks, and fuel cells. The electrolyzer generates hydrogen from water, the tanks store the produced hydrogen, and the fuel cells generate electricity from hydrogen without any greenhouse gases emission. These components are controlled through static power converters and are characterized and modeled for use in the negotiation process.
A data center is a set of machines organized in racks. These machines may have different characteristics, like processor speed and memory capacity. Every time a user accesses a website, for example, or submits tasks for executions, it consumes part of those resources, leading to a power consumption according to the amount of resources used.
There is an agreement on the quality of service between provider of the data center and the user. To be able to schedule user tasks when the renewable energy is available, it's necessary to characterize power requirements of the applications over time. The aim is to respect the quality of service agreed while using only renewable energy sources.
We are designing both the data center itself, the IT infrastructure, and the electrical infrastructure which manages the different renewable energy sources and the energy storage devices. Even if they have different objectives, the IT and electrical infrastructures are inherently linked, as the power consumed by the first need to be provided by the second. The negotiation process is here to conciliate them, to find the best compromise between their respective needs. Such an agreement concerns not only the immediate requirement, but also the expected requirements for the next few hours or the next days. In this way, each part can anticipate the future constraints, for instance, by storing the energy that will be required later. The negotiation itself is made by exchanging some power profiles, along with their cost and benefit information. Progressively, each part will add its own preferences until it allows to meet the constraints of the other part. Then the final solution will allow to satisfy both the quality of service and the energy availability.